Ready to create a classroom quiz all done through Microsoft PowerPoint? Great, me too. I'm Sarah Famicino. Hit that subscribe button and let's get started. When creating an interactive classroom quiz, you guys don't want to be forced to have to use many different applications just to engage your students. So that's why today we're sticking right inside Microsoft PowerPoint with the help of ClassPoint. What is ClassPoint, you say? ClassPoint is an interactive teaching add-in that allows you to ask your students questions, receive responses from them without ever having to leave PowerPoint. ClassPoint has a lot of different features like word cloud, slide drawing, interactive whiteboards, pick a name, just to name a few, that helps you engage your learners and aid in your teaching. But if you're just looking for a simple quiz to help motivate your students, then competition mode is the feature for you. So competition mode takes a regular multiple choice question, scores and ranks your students' responses based on their correctness and their speed to put them in a leaderboard. So let's go ahead, create one of these quizzes and show you how easy and fun it can be for both you and your students. Okay, we're in PowerPoint. I have an example file pulled up here with all the quiz content already created inside. First things first to make this interactive though is to click on the ClassPoint tab. If you don't have, download and install at classpoint.io. Otherwise then, just go ahead and click on the multiple choice icon here. So this just indicates that this slide is now interactive. So students can join your class, answer your questions when they're live by going to classpoint.app on any browser using any device. I'll go through an example of that student side in a little bit, but for now, let's turn up the heat of this normal multiple choice question and turn it into a competition mode question. To do that, just on the side question panel here, go ahead and click the competition mode button. Every competition mode question does have to have a correct answer. So make sure you choose the correct one. If you do have multiple correct answers, you have the option to do that as well. And then lastly, make sure the number of choices here corresponds to the number of choices on your slide. Now to really upgrade this quiz competition and add some pressure, let's go ahead and change these play options. So the play options determine the behavior of your button when you're presenting. So for example, it allows you to be a little bit more hands-off because you don't have to either physically push the button, it'll automatically minimize the results window, and it can close your submissions automatically as well. So for this example, when all my quiz competition questions are one right after the other, I do like to set all three of these. However, if you have your quiz competition mode questions spread throughout your lesson to boost up your students during class, that's totally okay, and you can still use these play options as well. But for now, that's it, guys. With just the click of a couple of those buttons, you've created your first competition mode question in PowerPoint. So now let's go ahead and run this question so you can see it all put together. Okay, to run these questions, let's get into our presentation mode. Today, I'm going to be using window mode. That way I can pull up a student side right next to this teacher side. So I can go ahead and split my screen and then go over to classpoint.app on any browser. And then this class code you see in the top corner of the presentation, you can go ahead and type in here and then your name. I've used this, so I have my name already joined. Click the join button and then you will see the student side. Back over here on the teacher's side, if you guys remember, we set that play option to automatically start the question when we get to its slide. So the next slide after this title slide is a question button slide. So if we go here, you guys will see that the question is now open. The options are pulled up on the student's side that they can go ahead and choose one and click submit. You guys also notice that the response window was minimized. We set that play option too. That way students are able to submit without being influenced by their classmates' results. If at any point anyone is taking a moment to respond to the question, you can always see who that is by clicking into this button and clicking on the live status button. So that way you're going to see who submitted and who hasn't yet. Once the timer has run out, the question will automatically close, since that is the last play option that we set, and you guys will be able to view the final results. So this is where the fun comes in. You can first show your students the correct answer. I'm sure you'll hear lots of booing or cheering, depending on if they got it right or wrong. And then where the real fun comes in is the leaderboard. So you can go ahead and click that and it will rank your students depending on if they got it right and how fast they submitted. So the faster your students submit with the correct answer, the higher they'll be up on that leaderboard. This leaderboard will update after every single question. So behind me, you'll see an updated leaderboard for after we run question number 2. And once you have hit all of the questions, they're all submitted, you guys can view the final leaderboard and see who has won the total competition. At any point when you're viewing the leaderboard, you can also choose to show the table. This table will show you a little bit more data on all of these results. And good news, you are able to export this as a CSV. So if you don't want to take the time during class to do that, if you close this window and we go back into our PowerPoint edit mode here, we can click on the leaderboard option and view the full leaderboard. And then you can also view this table and export from here. That way you don't have to take up time and now you can review or share this data as needed. Look how easy that was to create and run a quiz competition all right done through PowerPoint. ClassPoint has a lot of other features that you guys can watch the tutorials on in our YouTube page or check out some of the more information that's linked down in the description below. Leave a comment about how you guys create more interactive presentations, and I'll see you guys next time.